I was going to talk about Lat-Sau. Lat-Sau is just a drill. You should not be using Lat-Sau as a fighting method or a sparring contest. Okay? So what you're going to do is you're going to face your partner, both of your foot forward. You can either place your foot on the inside, or you can place your foot on the outside. Doesn't really matter which. The point of this is that if seeing Aaron steps backwards, I can feel the pressure and follow his foot. Okay? If I'm standing here and I'm watching somewhere else and he steps backwards, I can't feel it. Now I'm going to step in, he'll kick, and I'm going to get hurt. Okay? So that's what that's for. Once you've connected at the foot, then the first partner is going to throw a right punch, the other partner left back tap. They are not pushing to the side, so it is just straight down his centre. Once that pack is hit, I retract my hand, he will punch, I will pack. My hand comes back to Wu Sao, we do it again. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay? So once you've got the first stage of Lat Sau correct, and once you can now maintain your stance and control the centre point, the next thing you're going to be looking for is the mistakes that your opponent makes. Okay? So in this video, what we're going to be looking at is what happens if an opponent pushes your pack out or your punching hand to the wrong side of the body. Okay? Okay, so now I'm punching straight. Now what happens if my partner pushes my pack or my punch across the wrong side of my body is I clear with the other hand and come forward to the center. I retract my punching hand to Wu Sao. Okay? That is what you should be aiming for. What you should not be doing is as they push, letting this arm collapse so that they can get a line. That's the first mistake. Or, as they push, trying to come under too late, and now both my hands are pinned. I should not be reaching across my body to create the Lat Sau. It should be as soon as my hand crosses the center, the other one comes into the straight line. Okay? Okay, another mistake you constantly see in Lat Sau is people rotating their arm round rather than forward and back, forwards and back. So, I'm now going to show you, seeing Erin, exactly what happens if you make this mistake against a competent opponent. If you notice, as we did that, so if I slow down, as he follows me in, look, at no point, even if I'm really strong, he can hit me before I can lift him. Can you see? So, the arm must retract back, and if this hand stays, from here, if I push with my wrist and he's strong, my hand won't move. If I push with my elbow, I can go past his hand and make the strike work. Okay? So feel what your opponent's doing. If he now decides to press in, if I do this, if I'm now loading myself up and trying to hold him, whoever's stronger wins. If he presses in, I move my shape and I attack. I control the centre line. Okay? Next stage with Lat Sau is to look at how to deal with an opponent whose hands are no longer driving in a straight line towards your center, but are actually curving round you in either a hook punch or a haymaker form towards your head. So let's look at how we deal with that. Here, and then look, my hand is already on seeing Aaron's face. I've got my tarms out of control here. If I extend my structure, I've taken him off of his balance. Okay? Here. So what we've done is we've taken the tarms out, look, past my head. He can't hit my head. My hand is already through his head here. I'm driving my center towards my opponent. Okay? What a lot of people seem to feel the need to do is to start creating all these kung fu shapes that don't work, okay? The only time you should be creating from a Tan Sao over to a Bong Sao is when the energy is a diagonal energy across your body. If I take the same haymaker here and then turn my hand over, even with the best bottle sound in the world, I'm going to get smacked. It's only if seeing Aries suddenly decides to punch me in this chest, this shoulder, does bomb sound now work, because his energy came across that way. So the bomb sound worked. So as you can see, Tan Sao and the strike is here. I can either hit or I can place my hand beside, showing the opponent, the training partner, that I've made that strike. Okay? Now the wrong way. And now I got hit in the head. Okay? Now we're going to show you the how Bong Sao will work for going across the body. So as you can see, Bong Sao passed the shape to this hand. This hand is now free to strike. Okay?